a small little enterprising company being formed, most probably. And there was also Mobi, a beautiful thing, which I understood was spare capacity model. Are you with me? There's a huge plant. 60% is utilized, 40% is vacant. मैं जाके उधर बैठ गया. गाड़ी बंबई से बैंगलोर जा रही है बर्गर लेके, 60% यूटिलाइज, 40% हम जाके बैठ गए उसमें. तो आप बस जा रही है, आप लिफ्ट पूछते हो, क्या करते हो? यू नो समटाइम्स यू टेक लिफ्ट एंड द ड्राइवर चार्जेस यू 5 रुपीज फॉर द सेम ड्राइव. हाउ मच विल इट कॉस्ट यू? 300 रुपीज, बिकॉज इज गोइंग एम्प्टी. स्पेयर कैपेसिटी इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड.
It is very tempting to start other products also in your shop or store, whatever it is. So how do you stop it? I know standardization is really difficult if you have a lot of variety, but how do you deal with it? Do you get repeat? Say I have a family, only one person wants to eat a vada pav, maybe I'll go to some other place for my kids. So how do you manage?
See, that is very, very important. You know, in India, you go to Udupi in Mumbai, they have 350 menu. You know, menu dekhte hai, aadha ghanta lag jata hai aapko. You know, and everything tastes shoddy. So somewhere you have to say, 350 item bechna hai, aur kuch bhi bechna hai, ya char product bechenge, but log fir se aayenge. That's a call you have to take. And again, I think focus is very, very important. You take 1 spoon of sugar and put it in 6 cups. Or you take 1 spoon of sugar and put it in 1 cup. When it comes to marketing and consumer mind, if you are everything, I don't think it's a problem. We want to focus on vada pav and varieties of vada pav. So Monday, we say vada pav. Tuesday, we say palak makai. Wednesday, we say mixed vegetable vada pav. Thursday, we say Schezwan vada pav. Friday, we say cheese vada pav. So we have days for one on vada pav. But we serve everything together.
To me, it seemed that, you know, the model for expansion, for this food industry kind of thing, you know, expanding to a franchising model is a very natural kind of a thing. But from the reading the case, it appeared that you sort of went into this as a desperate measure of last resort when nothing else was working, then you went into franchising.
No, we definitely knew the franchisee because I had spent around 2-3 years in AppTech, you know, Apple. So I knew the franchisee thing. But somehow, the coincidence happened where we were in a bad situation and this thing also happened together. But otherwise, our original models were also franchising model only. We had only put 2 or 3 company-owned stores.
I have 2 questions. One is very generic one. You mentioned that Tata's and Birla's ne kyun nahi kiya. And should that really bother an entrepreneur on the ideation stage? That if I have an idea, should I really bother about why isn't this happening? I'm sure somebody thought about
it. No. That's a very negative way of taking it. You should never say, if your idea is there and you have conviction, you should go ahead and do it. Maybe wo log so gaye, maybe unke paas bahut already problems hai, bahut borrow kar chuke, existing danda chalane mein unka time aur age aa raha hai. So a lot of times it's very important that a new idea will only take off, and it will always come from new entrepreneurs. It will not come from existing big organization. They are so much saddled with their own past, their own operation issues, that innovation finds it difficult to happen in a very large organization.
And secondly, in the case somewhere has mentioned that when you were starting the business, you thought of giving opportunities and education and job opportunities to the downtrodden Indian. Has that really happened? Have you managed to do that?
See, indirectly, we say if you are running 125 stores, 4 store boys per store, 400-500 boys are working in our stores. So it's handholding that we are doing. Then the logistic guardian jitni 10 guardian chal rahi hai. The people have got employment. I would say basic employment kind of thing. But long term, we have plans of creating an education program for them, for everybody, so that we have a Goli quick service restaurant model diploma course. So that will happen. Employment will happen. Third is we are looking at an entrepreneurship model. Tomorrow, Wipro, Infosys, BPOs, IT Park. We'll have a financial franchisee who will invest. We'll have an operating franchisee who's a poor boy who will run the store. So there will be an entrepreneurship also that will come in.
So as you move into the other major cities in India, are you planning to go completely with a franchise model, or do you have to, or do you think you need to set up something like a flagship store in all of these places to actually bring up the attractiveness of what Goli Vada Pav is, and to improve the message, control the message, and thereby bring in the franchisees? And
As of now, what is happening is that the word of mouth is spreading very fast. The Google has happened. So earlier people used to do advertising. Today people search for products. So that is also a form of presence. So franchises are definitely coming in. But maybe a time will come, maybe the flagship store will be important. Maybe a company-owned store. But the first 4 or 5 years, we would say franchises, franchises, and franchises. By through agents.
Okay.